big day, Senior Sunday, the day where I am here and read to you all my big piece of what I have taken away from my years of high school, my years of youth, and of course, my years of growing up here in Trinity. I've been here for about 6 years, since I was like 6 years old and only in first grade. Gotta say, it's a pretty long time. And before I even stepped foot here, I really had no idea what church was and the fact that like, God even existed. However, I gotta say, that really all changed when I came here for the first time, and it all started when I went to children's liturgy. For those who don't know, children's liturgy is basically this bit in church where the kids would go downstairs to the upper croft and would get taught the stories of Jesus through storytelling, songs, and playing games together. I think my favorite part of children's liturgy was when we got to take home the Jesus doll at the end of every lesson. But what happened was one kid would be picked to take home this doll of Jesus for a week, and then they would make a journal entry about what you and Jesus did during the time you were at your house. Now, that said, I was quite notorious for hogging Jesus. So, but like, who wouldn't want the guy who healed the sick, walked on water, and literally rose from the dead to come to your house every week? I mean, like, how many of you can say that you had a sleepover with Jesus? No, come on, raise your hand. How many of you have had a sleepover with Jesus? I gotta say, it's a pretty high honor. I literally had Jesus come with me to the hospital when I got my tonsils taken out. That's pretty swell. And somewhere in the depths of this church was a journal entry written by like 6-year-old me about Jesus coming to the hospital. So anyway, the main takeaway from children's liturgy was how I learned one of the most important things of my faith. I learned that God is my friend. I realized that God is someone I can trust. Someone I can always have by my side no matter what. Someone who I can talk to, pray to. I mean, I always assumed that was obvious. I mean, after all, if a literal talking tomato and a talking cucumber can say at the end of every episode of VeggieTales that God made you special and he loves you very much, why wouldn't I believe that? I mean, over time, I learned that there are some people out there who are afraid of God. There are some people who utterly despise God for everything he's done. I mean, I've heard people ask, like, if God really cares, why are there all these school shootings? If God isn't only here to torture us, why does he let people starve and people be homeless and let all these bad things happen to the world? Well, over time I've found a bit of an explanation about this, but it kind of requires a little bit of analogy because I'm an analogy guy. So like, my mom and I have this really weird thing where we constantly make comparisons between our own faith and books in the Harry Potter franchise. I don't know, it's just like the thing we do. But anyway, I gotta say, what I'm about to say is literally like a huge spoiler for Harry Potter 7, Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows. If you've all read it, you don't care for spoilers, you're all good. But if you're like currently reading it and halfway through the series, cover your ears right now. I do not want to be the cause of the spoilers. I'm warning you, I'm about to spoil some major stuff, so if you hear this, and then you come to me later and say, whoa, why did you spoil me? I will look you in the eye and I will say, you utter fiend, I warned you. Alright. So anyway, the book prior, Dumbledore had already passed away, and it was up to 17-year-old Harry to find all the Horcruxes to defeat Lord Voldemort. However, Hogwarts headmasters have this weird thing where, like, the moment they die, they kind of, like, reappear as a sentient, moving, talking painting in the headmaster's office. I literally do not remember if it is ever explained how these paintings get here. There's literally, like, generations of these paintings. So anyway, there's a painting of Dumbledore in the headmaster's office that can literally give Harry all the answers and tell him exactly how to defeat Voldemort right here, right now. Heck, even Snape could have used his Patronus, like how he gave Harry the Sword of Gryffindor to give him Dumbledore's portrait as well, or like a literal checklist of instructions on what to do for Dumbledore. But he doesn't. Dumbledore leaves it up to Harry to find Horcruxes and learn about the Hallows and how he'll have to accept his own death before defeating Voldemort. In other words, God, like Dumbledore, is watching, but not doing things for us. He leaves things for us to do because it's up to us to find the answer to live in. I honestly believe that God has left us everything we need to create a perfect world where everyone can live together in harmony. But there's just one thing that we're missing. One thing that by the name of Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc, where a bunch of high school students are trapped in a school and are forced into a killing game of death and murder by the hands of a psychotic teddy bear by Monokuma. I could not make this up if I wanted to. At the first glance, this show may look like a terrible fever dream nightmare for violent, obsessed people, but it's not the case, because the main message of the story is how hope can bloom in the most tragic of situations. At the end of the first game of the first season, the protagonist, Makoto Naegi, learns how the outside world of the school is literally the apocalypse, and society was brought to its knees by his despair-obsessed classmate, one Junko Emishima. But after hearing this, Makoto still clings on to hope. Even though there seems like there's nothing left out there in the world except terrorism, violence, and utter despair, he believes there's still hope for everything to be all right again. After Makoto and his five surviving classmates escape the school, they see the terrible state the world has come to. But they don't give up on hope. They end up joining a group known as the Future Foundation, built up together by Hope's Peak Academy alumni, made for the sake of fighting despair and returning the world to normal. This is the kind of hope I like to believe in. Even when it seems like despair is already won, even when it seems like all these school shootings and acts of gun violence are in this world, I truly believe there's a way to end it, and there will come a day where it all comes to an end. I know there's a lot of people who have already given up on God and given up on the current state of our world, but me giving up? Well, I don't think that's what my friend Ben Wheeler would have wanted. Because when he was still alive, Ben was a boy who was filled to the brim with hope. And for those 6 years he walked this earth, he filled others with hope as well. With his creativity, his humor, and his bravery. That day when he never came home from Sandy Hook will stick with me forever. Yeah, I'd erase the past if I could. But that's not in my power. Besides, there are some things in this world that have to be remembered. Ben was real. I can't pretend like he never existed. Giving up on hope would be like giving up on him. And I know, for a fact, he'd want me to keep believing in the goodness of this world. Because that's how he was able to see the world when he was still here. That's why I want to be someone who can spread hope by empowering others. In the future, I want to bring hope with me so I can carry it within myself and spread it to others. So, I'd like to end this off with two things. For one, thank you for everyone who's helped build this community for me. Everyone in this church has been with me for so long and has helped me build up my faith over time. And I hope this community can just be as strong as it has been for me for the next generation of kids. And second, a quote from Makoto Naegi at the end of Danganronpa 3, the end of Hope's Peak High School. You don't have to know the future to move forward. You just have to walk with your memories, look up to the sky, and say to yourself, there will always be.